So the reason why I went on this cruise was because it was one of my best friend's bachelor parties, and he wanted to do a four-day cruise leaving Miami. We did it on the Carnival Sensation, and the first day was pretty much just going down to the Keys. The second day was just spending half the day in the Keys, half the day at sea. The third day was getting to Cozumel, Mexico, and the fourth day was a day at sea on our way back to Miami. Let me tell you some things that I really liked about the cruise. Number one, the food was really good and it was much better than I expected. The second thing I liked was the water slide. I'm a big kid at heart, so anything like that gets me really excited. And I went down that slide like 50 times a day because it was that much fun. So the third thing that I liked was that they had a mixology bar on the cruise, which was pretty good, and it was a nice relief over those generic drinks that they serve at the pool or at a random bar. So I did most of my drinking from that bar and I just walked around with my drink. The fourth thing that I liked was my room. Now I had two other roommates, and it may sound crazy that you're on a cruise ship and the rooms are generally small. Why would you do that? Well, we got the grand suite with a balcony, and that was plenty of room for three of us. The bathroom was bigger. It was pretty nice. The fifth thing that I liked was pretty cool. It was the comedy club. The comedians that they had on board were pretty funny, and I saw the same show twice because it was that funny. Some things I didn't like. The first thing was that there were a lot of kids on board. Now, I don't have a problem with kids generally, but when you're so close to them and you're surrounded by them, you kind of have to curb your behavior, you know, in terms of the things you talk about, in terms of what you say. So you just have to keep that in mind. So the second thing that I didn't like much was the music. It seemed like there was just one playlist that was played over and over again. And there were way too many line dancing songs, like one after the other, like line dancing, come on. So the third thing that I didn't like was that the cruise felt very crowded at first. I guess it's because when you first get on and it's the first day, everyone kind of just chills at the upper deck, and it just felt a little claustrophobic for me. But after a while, people did dissipate and they started to move around the ship. So my first tip is to get a room with a balcony. Now, it might cost a little bit more money to get a room with a balcony, and a lot of people might say that it isn't worth it because, hey, are you gonna spend that much time in your room, or are you gonna be out and about at the upper deck, enjoying the food, enjoying the atmosphere? But the reason why I feel like you should get a room with a balcony is because at the end of the day, you will spend time in your room, and that's the only place where you're gonna have any sort of privacy, and it allows you to enjoy the water and enjoy the view and enjoy a sunset by yourself without anyone interfering or without you having to hear a conversation or anything that'll take you out of your zone. Hit like, hit subscribe, and I'll catch you later.